Would you turn with me again to Proverbs chapter 1? We will begin reading at verse 20. Wisdom crieth without. She uttereth her voice in the streets. She crieth in the chief place of concourse, in the openings of the gates. In the city she uttereth her words, saying, How long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity? And the scorners delight in their scorning, and fools hate knowledge. Turn you at my reproof. Behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you. I will make known my words unto you. In verse 20, we find for the first of several times in the book of Proverbs, wisdom being personified. This personification of wisdom can be found in none other than Jesus Christ. Colossians 2:3, speaking of Jesus, reads, In whom are hid all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. He, Jesus, is the ultimate personification of wisdom. And here, at the very outset of wisdom's cry, we find wisdom crying from without. Solomon writes that she uttereth her voice in the streets. This picture of wisdom crying in the streets goes to imply that she has not been welcomed in the houses and homes of individuals. The picture here is that people have shut wisdom out. We have shut Christ out. We have shut His instruction out. We have shut the Word of God out. We have shut out this knowledge, and we have shut wisdom out of our lives. Therefore, wisdom is crying out in the street. Verse 21 tells us that wisdom is crying out in the chief places and in the gate, in the palaces where princes and wealthy people are able to hear. In the gate, this is the place where men of the city would sit and where business would be taken care of. But also, wisdom is crying in the city. Wisdom, Christ personified, does not discriminate. This message is for all, and it is to be heard by all. Wisdom is being cried aloud for all to hear. It is not just for a select few people to hear, but God's message is being spread abroad for all of us to hear. But when we get to verse 22, we will find that wisdom's cry goes by unheeded. Verse 22 reads, How long, ye simple ones, will you love simplicity? And the scorners delight in their scorning, and fools hate knowledge. Here, we are shown three types of people and their response to wisdom's cry. First is the simple. This is the naive person who is naive to these godly principles. The second is the scorner, the ones who despise, mock, and reject the things of God. The third individual is the fool who rebels against God and does not care for the things of God. Wisdom is crying to them and asking, How long will you turn from the things of God? How long will you continue in your same old way? But verse 23, there's a call to repentance. He says, Turn you at my reproof. Behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you. I will make known my words unto you. The sinner here is instructed to turn at my reproof. Wisdom is calling for those who hear to turn at her reproof, to turn back to God. This is the same message which Jesus Christ proclaimed. Repent. The call today is the same as when Solomon wrote Proverbs. It's the same as when John the Baptist and when Jesus preached. It's a call for all of us to repent, to turn back to God. And there's a promise. If you turn back to Him, He will pour out His Spirit upon you today. Today, if you turn to God, He will pour His blessings and His Spirit upon you. He will reveal His Word to you. He will show you the way in which you are to live. He will guide you. He will provide for you. He will help you. But you have to hear His cry. My prayer is that we would open our hearts and our homes to the Lord and to His wisdom, that we would not be like the simple, we would not be like the scorners or the fools that reject that wisdom, but that we would turn from that way and that sin, and we would look to God. We would hear that wisdom He has. We would heed that wisdom He has, and that we would go in that right way.